Hi, I'm Sarah from SewingMastery.com, where we take sewing machines, open them up, and then do a video on every page of the manual. So make sure you check out all the links below as we cover all the brand new AccuQuilt dies that have made the 2021 list, plus some of our other online courses that might be of interest to you. So AccuQuilt has been around for quite a while, and I know a lot of you might have even gotten AccuQuilt fabric cutting systems for Christmas. So now you're looking at what dies should I buy next. So this top 10 list has always been interesting to me as I watch different dies kind of move up and down the list as new dies come out each year and which ones actually take those top 10 spots. So again, there are links below where you can purchase every one of these single dies individually, so you can click on them. Plus, we actually have the top 20 dies. So if you've got a lot of these, then what are those next couple popular dies? Now, once again, AccuQuilt has free patterns for each of these dies. Plus, if you have an embroidery machine, any of these dies that have reached our list that are in the applique category will have complimentary embroidery designs that go with these dies. And tell you the truth, little secret here, you as an embroiderer can download those designs even if you don't have an AccuQuilt cutter. Now, of course, it'll be so much easier if you do because the cutting system cuts those shapes so perfectly, making it really easy to do your applique. But if you are interested in just checking out free embroidery designs, again, make sure you click on the links below and they will take you to each of the free patterns and free embroidery designs. So starting at number 10, going to number 1, plus I have 3 of the runners up that almost made the top 10 list, but should be mentioned no matter what. Number 10, the Crazy Patch Die, finishing at 6 inches square, allows you to cut up lots of scraps. That is one thing AccuQuilt has been known for, in providing dies that can use up those smaller pieces. Plus, this die has been screen printed, so it has each of the sections labeled, so as you work with them, they don't get mixed up. Number 9, the Log Cabin, that finishes 12 inches as a block size. So this is a great way also to use up scraps, but also if you have a planned log cabin where every one of those strips are perfectly cut to the length, and if you are doing scrappy, you can lay those fabrics on those individual pieces and get lots of the correct pieces cut at once. Remember, AccuQuilt loves about 6 layers of cotton fabric, and you can really make fast cutting out of any of these very time-consuming rotary cutter projects, and they're perfectly accurate. Number 8 is the Starry Path Block, finishing at a 9-inch size, and this is one of the newer dies for AccuQuilt, and who would want to cut all those pieces anyway? When they create dies, every piece is cut perfectly and accurately, so sewing these complex designs are a total breeze. Remember, make sure you check out the free pattern maybe before you buy the die and just see exactly how easy it is going to be to stitch together. Number 7 is the 1.5 strip cutter that finishes at 1-inch wide strips. Now that seems like, why would I even want to have strips that small? But believe me, when patterns call for that strip, when you lay fabric out and you try to cut, it is sometimes hard to get that piece totally accurately straight, especially when you have a fold in your fabric. So this is one way to finally get an accurate strip that is cut that narrow. This next die, number 6, is one that always makes the list. If you don't have the die that cuts 5-inch charm squares, you are missing out. Again, great way to use up those last couple pieces of fabric after a quilt is done. Maybe make yourself a handful of blocks for later use. And there are so many patterns that start with that 5-inch square, always finishing down to 4.5. And remember, 5-inch squares cut in half make a perfect rectangle that can complement those 5-inch squares. So if you haven't added this die to your collection, this should be the year that you do so. Before we enter into the top 5 category, I want to make sure to invite you to our online courses. If you are a sewer and you love to use your decorative stitches, or maybe you don't use them to their fullest, I'd like you to check out our Stitching Cosmos online course, where we actually take all those amazing stitches, all those accessory feet that maybe came with your machine and you just kind of wondered what they do, and check out how you can use them to finish over 25 different sewing techniques, all while using about 18 different presser feet. So if you want to take your sewing up a notch, maybe you're just tired of sewing straight and you're ready to learn something more, check out our 10 free videos that you can watch to see if this course is right for you. Plus, as we get to some of our applique AccuQuilt design dies, you might find yourself wishing you knew more about your embroidery machine. And I invite you to our Embroidery Essentials online course, where we help you master your embroidery machine while working through 15 different embroidery techniques, including applique, where you can find you and your embroidery machine to be on the same page. So if your machine is scaring you a little bit, that's the course to take before you dive into some of these wonderful AccuQuilt applique dies. Getting back to our top 10 list, number 5 is the Arkansas Traveler die, which will finish as a 12-inch block size. Now, once again, these shapes have a variety of different ways that you can put them together. The combinations and outcomes are truly endless. Make sure you check out all the free pattern options that are available on AccuQuilt's website. Number 4, the 6-inch Hunter Star Block. This is one block. It is such a classic block, usually done with two colors. There is a variety of pieces that make this actually turn out so classic. And if you're looking for a fun, dynamic way to create your next quilt, a Hunter Star should be on your bucket list of quilts to make. Number 3, the Camper Die. Oh my gosh, how cute is this? So I'm sure you know somebody that is a camper fanatic. Maybe you go camping yourself, but this is so fun. It really just tells a story about summer travel and getting out and enjoying the outdoors. Remember, this would be a free embroidery design that you can download, so make sure you click the links below that we've provided to find all the information on this particular die. Number 2, the Gingerbread Cookie. How fun is this? Yes, though it is seasonal, it is something that you can be creative with and change up those colors when you do your applique cutouts. Remember, all you have to do is actually fuse fusible web on the back of your fabric before running it through the die, and these pieces are super easy to applique in place, whether by the sewing machine or with your embroidery machine. Now, the number 1 die is a classic, the 2.5-inch strip cutting die. This one will cut enough strips for binding for a queen size quilt. But 2.5-inch strips are what you find in jelly rolls. It's what you can use sashing for, of course, binding. Plus, we even have a video of how to use this strip die for cutting binding on the bias. So we'll also put that link below for you to check out. I want to sneak in 3 more as runners up to our top 10 list. Number 1, an applique gnome designs. Somehow gnomes became popular over the last couple years, and I have a feeling we're going to continue to see them going forward in 2021. They are kind of cute. I've always had something about gnomes in the past. I think they kind of freaked me out, but they have become a lot cuter than how I originally was introduced to gnomes. So I'm okay with this one, but it is once again an embroidery design, but super easy to do an applique on your sewing machine. The holiday medley is always a top winner for me, and the 12-inch block Morning Star is one, again, a classic quilt, but I would not want to cut it out with a rotary cutter. Too many flipping and flopping of my rulers to get the most accurate cuts. Put your fabric on an AccuQuilt die and run it through 6 layers at a time, and just realize how much more efficient your fabric cutting will be with this system. Now, if you're interested in what fabric cutting is all about with AccuQuilt, again, we'll put links below where you can check out all the products and see which ones are right for you. If this video has been helpful for you, make sure you leave us a comment. Tell me which one your favorite die is. And don't forget to like this video and give it a share. Sharing is caring. And subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can see what other things I'll be working on next.